You know, Freddie says to me once, he said, the smartest fish I ever see, he says, was one that jumped out of the water and into my boat up to Kennebago. He was just a little fella, no longer than 6 inches. So I throwed him back, but he jumped into the boat again. You see, he seemed to like riding in the boat, so I kept him. But as soon as I got a chance, I put him in a bucket of water. When I got back to camp, I showed him to Dickie Baker. I told Dickie that that was the smartest fish in the world. You see, to prove it, I showed him the fish's high forehead and the wide space between the ears, you see, and the long eyebrows. Well, I put him in a barrel of water, and then I started teaching him. I taught him to come when I whistled, and when he come, I'd scratch his dinky little head. After a while, I'd take him out of that barrel, you know, and let him walk in the grass. Well, at first, for just a little while, you see. But then, for quite a spell... you know, finally, he was so used to being out of water, he didn't need water anymore. That's right. I mean, he only used water to drink. Well, eventually, that trout went everywhere I went. By now, you see, I had taught him how to speak, you know, and roll over, and kind of shake fins like that. Well, then one day, we went for a walk. Well, Tommy was following me along. It was his name, Tommy. Well, the path we took went over this brook. Now, I didn't think nothing of it when I went over the bridge, you see, but there was one plank off, and poor Tommy, he tumbled through the hole into the water and drowned.